Full name, Akintunde Ibitayo Akinwande, otherwise known as Tayo Akinwande. I grew up in Nigeria. The school library, you have all these Time Life books that were always there. And there was one specific one on technology or engineering, and it talked about MIT. It was always the thought that MIT is where magic happens. And that was the theme of that book. So that has always stuck in my head. I still remember the picture of somebody doing orbital mechanics, walking on the board. I still want to go find that book and find which classroom so I can go there and do the same. Ofa was a small town, but now it's a big city. Petroleum and oil was very prominent. That was the expectation. Oh, you're going to go there and make a lot of money. But that did not fascinate me. The school that I went to was a boarding school. The students who were there before us, people would take us out in the evenings to look at stars. The first satellite went to the moon and the circumnavigated. That was my first year. We couldn't see it, but we knew it was out there. But the most fascinating thing for me was when Neil Armstrong landed on the moon, we were able to see the pictures, meaning TV pictures. How did that happen? What goes on into the radio? Why could somebody talk to somebody on the moon? So those questions were more interesting to me. All the radios I could find are taken apart. Well, was I able to assemble them? No. My father was a vice principal in a secondary school. My mother was teaching elementary school. She always got me on schedule. And my father was the one who made me dream. A perfect combination for me. The area that I worked on, if you want to call it, is called microelectromechanical systems. It's both electrical, mechanical, and you build into a system. I've always been fascinated in my, you know, what's the problem I'm solving? And what difference does it make? After working in industry for a while, it dawned on me that I will have more impact in a university than in a company. The most fascinating to me was MIT for all those schools. Most of the universities you will not be able to find in one single project all the expertise you need. So that's something about MIT. You will always be able to go across departments. It allows interdepartmental labs. And it's the same way dealing with students. I've had students from physics, I've had students from mechanical engineering, I've had students from material science and engineering work with me on different projects. Anytime I teach a class, undergraduate class, I always learn something by their probing questions, by what they're looking to get, but gives me new insights sometimes. And that's always the kind of environment I like, where I'm learning something new all the time.